I grew up on cartoons that there's not really any depth to them. They're still fun to watch, you know, Tom and Jerry and Popeye. They're fun to watch, but they didn't go dark or into deep places at all. And anime did. Anime was, you know, very, you know, theatrical, and the storylines were great. Eventually we got the series, like the Batman series and stuff like that, was much darker. You know, obviously did well as well at that time. But the anime just exploded, I think, because of that, you know. Akira being one of the first ones that I had seen that I knew was anime. And I was like, holy cow, what is this show? And that really kind of got me into anime. Like, I just wanted to see more. But it wasn't accessible. You know, we had, I don't know if, do you guys remember Blockbuster? Are they still around? All right, so when Blockbuster was around, I would go and try to find anime. And I didn't know how it was. There was like volumes of anime, you know? And the problem is, when I went in, there would be like volumes 1 and then 5 and 7. And it's like, wait, what? And then you get it. And I was like, oh, I'm missing a lot, you know? So now it's obviously different, but then it was really tough, you know? I also think part of things being there, that kind of demand also kind of created that explosion, I guess, that boom. People really wanted it, and then, you know, just kept going.
One role or one series that you've been part of there that really means the most to you?
That means the most? Oh, gosh. I don't know if there's one. There are many. You know, a lot of them, like, Trigun changed it all for me, you know? But then throughout, there's been so many. For me, it's kind of like... I don't know, moments in my life that, you know, at this time, because a lot of times the series it'll impact you quite a bit, you know, or you'll work on something like Code Geass and then just think, oh, this is a really cool show. I hope people like it. And then you meet people where something that you've worked on has changed their life or helped them through a dark time. And then you realize how important those things are. So for me, there's a lot of, series that I really like. Even some of the smaller things that I've worked on where I had no idea, you know, the impact that it would have. Even shows that I hated or games that I didn't like working on or whatever had some kind of value to me, you know. Oh, I'll tell you this one because I don't know the name of the game. But I worked on this video game. Have no idea what it was called. I got called in the night before. They were like, hey, can you come and do some miscellaneous voiceover for a video game? And I was like, yeah, sure. So I go in, and then they're like, all right, well, you're going to be playing Goblin number 13. And so I go in, and I'm like looking, and I was like looking at the script, and I was like trying to find the character so I could see what I'm saying, figure out what I'm supposed to do. And I look, and Goblin number 13 just has like vowels, like O's, O-A-A-A, E-I-I-I. I'm like, what is this? You know, I was like, hey, it's just, what are all these vowels? What are these means? I was like, oh, they're goblin noises. I was like, what do you mean they're goblin noises? And then it's like, oh yeah, yeah, you're just gonna, you know, just do some goblin noises. And I was like, I don't want a goblin noise. I'd never done any kind of like character voices or anything. And I'm like, I don't know any goblins. He's like, you know, just like a goblin. And I had this guinea pig when I was little that I would talk to. And I was like, and it was like, yeah, you do that. And then I was like, okay, cool. So for 4 hours, I was like, you know, I'm like, fall off a cliff, you know, get stabbed, you know. So I did that for 4 hours, screaming top of my lungs, just, and at the end of the session, I couldn't talk. I was like, and I was like, thanks, guys. And the next day, I was supposed to work on this new series. I'm supposed to play a young kid voice, but I couldn't do it. And so I got replaced because I couldn't do the voice. So even something like that had an impact in my life. Because never again will I agree to a video game so close to working on another show, you know, especially if I have to do a kid voice. So it has...
Never go full goblin.
I went full goblin for that, for sure. because it was the first kind of like charactery thing that I'd ever done. So I'm like, I'm going for it. And yeah, I paid for it. At the same time, it's like I had to. That's kind of my mentality on anything that I work on, you know, any show. I go full on. Like, I really want to get into the character because I feel like if I'm not 100% in, somebody out there watching is going to be like, you know? And exactly, that Goblin 13 really stood out. But yeah, I don't even know the name of the game. So I always ask people, you guys play any games where a goblin was like, I don't know. But if you hear a goblin, it's like, and you just, that's Johnny. There's a lot of things. I've learned quite a few things, you know. There's just how to work the mic, how to be in the studio around producers and directors and other people, how to be respectful. There's just so many things, you know. I'll start with that or something. So if you go in on you're working on a show, a lot of times you don't know what you're working on. Sometimes you will, you have an idea. But many times you just go in, you have no idea. Then the director, the writer might be there, the creator might be there, producer might be there, whoever. And then they tell you what the show is, who you're playing, what you're supposed to be doing. And a lot of times in your mind you think, this sounds stupid. It sounds like the dumbest idea in the world. And some people voice that, or they laugh, you know, when they hear something ridiculous, you know. But I always kind of play it safe. I'm like, you don't know what it's going to be like at the end, you know. So just always be respectful, you know. Take it all in. You know, if it's supposed to be funny, then yeah, you can, you know, be lighthearted about it. But yeah, take it all in and you know, commit yourself 100%. Go full goblin. Go full goblin on it. And yeah, just commit yourself to it, you know. I don't know. Other tips would be try not to drink like a ton of milk or eating a lot of cheese beforehand so you're not all smacky. Yeah, try not to pop your peas, you know, pass them under the mic or something. Yeah, have a lot of water.
Ash the Stampede, I think, of all the characters you've played, is a completely unique one. Can you talk a little bit about why you think, of all the characters in that wonderful world of anime, he's one that people still have so much affection for?
And he's just a likable character, you know? Love and peace, you know? That was, it's his thing, you know? He didn't want to hurt anybody, you know? He was just kind of, I don't know how to do it. I mean, there's so much to that one. For me also, it's very special because it was the first one I worked on. I was, you know, like I had mentioned before, I was on Power Rangers, the very, you know, cheesy kids show. I called myself the background ranger because I was in the background most of the time, like, right, you know, or waiting for a moment to go like, yay. But I didn't say a whole lot, you know, especially earlier on. And I wasn't really an actor then either. I was just like kind of, when's the fight scenes happening? And so it was, you know, through that dark time where I'd like learned music and was like, I need to figure out this acting thing. Then I booked that role and I was like really committing myself and like, I got to take this seriously. Had a great director that really walked me through technical things as far as like working a mic, being a voice actor, and was very patient with me in that time too. And but for that character specifically, he was just so wild and so goofy at times. And I was trying to understand, why is he so goofy? And then you don't realize until later on in the series, for me at least, he was putting on this facade. Yeah, I mean, it is his personality, but he's really pushing it and really putting it on because he doesn't want people to know, you know. He doesn't want to know who he is and things like that at certain times. But I think I'm going off on a tangent. But, I think there's so many elements to that person, Vash, that I think people like. And I think it's just because he's really just genuine. And he's a genuine, nice guy. And he's just a person you would be rooting for, you know. A guy you want to go have donuts with. He might not share, but
you're not getting any donuts.
Yeah, maybe that's not a good idea.